Howdy and hello, I'm OhDough, hope you're doing good, and let's talk about the modifiers and how they affect stratagems in a way that makes no sense. But first, words of the head of product testing at Arrowhead, the folks that make Helldivers 2. You need to rely on your stratagems and the stratagems of your team to deal with all enemies effectively, either by eagle strikes, orbitals, support weapons, or turrets. Some of your loadout slash team should be tailoring their loadout to killing the weaker stuff more efficiently. Basically, use your stratagems more and use a wider variety of stratagems. That's the main premise I got from that. Makes sense to me. This is in direct contrast to what the game tells me whenever I load into a match and I see certain modifiers like complex stratagem plotting. Stratagem call-in time increased by 100%. That may not seem like a big deal, but it is. I'll explain that later. Orbital fluctuations. Stratagem cooldown increased by 50%. It now takes, not twice, but 50% longer for my stratagems to come off cooldown, for my support weapons, and basically everything else. What? Atmospheric interference. Orbital stratagems scatter increased. Your orbitals will now just miss. You throw it in one spot, you wanted to hit that direct spot, and now they miss, based on a modifier. It only affects orbitals though, does not affect eagle airstrikes, which means that I basically just don't run orbitals when this happens, which I think is kind of lame. Ion storms. This is not a big deal, but it's worth mentioning. Ion storms intermittently disable stratagems. So the weather can be kind of bad and it just cuts out your stratagems. Kind of like how when it storms outside and it just turns off for some reason, even when it's not that bad. This is kind of that. AA defenses. Stratagem slots reduced by one. Hey guys, use stratagems more often. And yet we have one less sometimes. Mind you, I'm not saying anything negative here. I'm pointing out how they're saying one, like how the devs are saying one thing, but the game is saying another. That's the main premise here. And I do enjoy the game. I play it every day to get all that out the way. These modifiers are not fun to play with. They don't really make you get better. They just make you wait. And to explain that in a, I guess, an example here. Let's say you're going to a theme park, or let's say you're going to Schlitterbahn. You want to ride a water slide and you see the line is 2 hours long. You say to yourself, I'm going to not ride that ride based on the wait time. And the folks in line say, just get better. Skill issue. Why are you so bad? Why are you so bad at waiting in line? When in reality, all you'd be doing is what they're doing, which is waiting. There is no getting better at waiting in line. You could maybe find something else to do, but when you're playing a video game, which is what Helldivers 2 is, you want to play the video game. And these do not really coincide with a great user experience, because they just make you wait. Now, speaking of waiting, call-in time increased by 100%. Complex stratagem plotting. This makes it so your dropship now takes twice as long to land. And what I've noticed, even on Helldive in some cases, that doesn't really mean there's more enemies to face. Sometimes you're just waiting an extra 2 minutes and there's nothing to shoot at. So it's just wasting your time. I find that to be abysmally boring. And I believe that most modifiers in most games are horrendous. I think that they are a very lazy thing to add. Truth be told, it's not just a shot at Arrowhead or Helldivers 2. I have the same view in Dauntless and Remnant 2 in most games, because most modifiers do not serve a good experience to the player. They just cause headaches. And most of them don't even make you really get better. And especially in this situation, you're just waiting. There's nothing that I can really do to get better about waiting an extra 50% duration in time for my resupply to drop down. I just sit there longer. How is that not boring? And it adds up too. These aren't like, oh, 50% or an extra few seconds, what's a big deal? Look at your support weapons. Now I have to wait twice as long. If I use the anti-tank, which if you're using anti-tank, you pair it with another support weapon most of the time. But folks don't do that, I'm not sure why. But let's say I'm using that. Now I'm just waiting an extra 30 seconds. That's still kind of low, not a big deal. If I'm using anything else, it's going to be roughly a 7 minute cooldown turned into around 10 minutes. What the F for the exosuit? It goes from 10 minutes to 15 minutes. Where is the skill there? Where is the get better portion that I just can't see it? Maybe I'm just that bad at the game. I do not believe these modifiers do anything to make the experience better. In fact, there was actually one modifier that changed stratagems in a way that I thought was interesting. And that was scatter. It made it so as far as at least the way it was written, I didn't really play with it that much, but the way it was written said scatter stratagem modifier thing made it so it would scatter the code for your stratagems, meaning you wouldn't be able to use the memorized thing you had for said stratagem, and instead you'd have to input a different code. That's fine. You can overcome that if you're good at seeing what's happening, relaying the information of the arrows and the directions you see. You could quickly overcome that. You're not just waiting extra arbitrary. You're not waiting extra time based on some arbitrary nonsense. It's something that you can actually get better to do. The problem with that potentially is, I guess, some folks. I'm not sure if dyslexia plays a role here if you use the arrow keys, but maybe the devs felt it wasn't exactly fair. I'm not sure exactly why they removed it, but that's what comes to mind for me. Because I do know that folks use macros, which a lot of folks don't like the idea of. I don't, by the way. I'm just saying that some folks do. And they use voice commands as well. And apparently in Japan or something, you can use voice commands. It's built into the game. That's what I've heard, but obviously I don't know if that's the case because I don't have the game in Japan. So I don't know. Anywho, it's just, I really want people to understand, specifically the devs, if possible, it'd be fantastic, that these are not fun modifiers. There's a way to make modifiers that are less egregious, that are maybe more engaging. This is not it. It might be wise to maybe try ones that give you a benefit and a downside. Like, I don't know, for instance, you have like a negative aspect that could be whatever, if it makes sense, and the positive would be increased fire damage or something like that. I don't know, but then that makes balance kind of weird. So honestly, I think the best solution is to get rid of any modifier that affects stratagems in a way the player can't overcome by being better at the game, by acquiring some kind of skill progression, such as the scatter gem thing. Different code, but if you see the code and input it quickly, you're chilling. You could even try one where it's like, what's it called? Those authenticator apps that have like a rotating code, every 10 seconds it changes. If you want to get really rambunctious, you can do that. And I'd be okay with that. That would suck for a lot of people, but I'd be okay with that. That, if we're talking about skill and get better, that makes way more sense than just waiting extra time. But maybe I care about time more than some folks do. I just feel like there's much better ways to go about modifying the gameplay that could lead to more enjoyability. This ain't it. Especially if your whole design philosophy is to have us use our stratagems and rely on our stratagems. Why would I want to rely on stratagems that take forever to drop down? This is also why I like the idea of support weapons being good against the majority enemies, which, fun fact, they are against the automatons. The vast majority of support weapons are great against automatons in every fashion and way you can think of. First the bugs. Nah. Anywho, thanks for watching. Have a good day. Peace.